Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Hopefully your Friday is going well. Three videos this week. I said I was gonna try to be better, and I'm working on it. If you didn't see Wednesday's video highlighting my new routine, you gotta go back and check it out, because this is going to help to explain how I could work out in the manner I'm working out in. So, to not give away too much of Wednesday's video, my workout is exceedingly long, going from weight training to something cool, to something cool, to something cool, encompassing 3 hours, almost 4 hours with drive time of working out. And only one thing is getting me through all of this lifting, and that is what I like to call MTS runaround punch. Now, you got five things here. A shaker cup, which is highly, highly important, because just dry scooping this into your mouth, not very fun. I use the Cyclone cups from MTS. They have a lot of different kinds. This one is fantastic. I don't even think I have one of the old school models with the little metal shaker ball in it. I hate those things. These are way better. If you don't have these, they're a little bit expensive. They last forever in the dishwasher, and I highly recommend them. Again, those are Cyclone cups, and they have, I mean, Stormtrooper ones. You could get Batman, the Hulk. This one just happens to be a Tigerfitness standard lifting one, and they usually come free with order, so check those sales ones. You might get this for free anyways. The main ingredients is this bit right here, not necessarily in any particular order, although my OCD likes the descending it right here. So huge thing, if you guys don't already take it for those long workouts, and again, it doesn't have to be as long as mine, but if for standard workouts, aminos right here are super, super necessary. They're not gonna impart any energy, but what they're gonna do is help your body continue that energy throughout your long workout. You gotta think aminos are, like, that's nutrition. So the less your body has to turn towards cannibalizing its own muscle groups, this will help you keep going. If you train fasted, if you train with carbs, it doesn't matter. This will help keep the energy in the gym by imparting a little bit of that nutrition. Second thing on the list, Ruckus. Ruckus is a pre-workout. There's two different kinds you can get from MTS, Clash and Ruckus. The only difference besides some of the main ingredient switches is Ruckus doesn't have creatine. And since I'm trying to drop a little bit of extra weight, creatine, as you guys well know, if you've seen some of the videos, is a cellular hydrator. Thus, you will hold a little bit of extra water. I drink a ton of water. I don't need to worry about too much of the endurance aspects of the potential, like, bonus from creatine. So Ruckus doesn't have creatine. Don't gotta worry about it. It goes in here. This comes in pineapple, and that's probably my favorite flavor. I've been doing that for a long time, so I switched to the blue raspberry. Then we got Naturalite. Now, if you've never used this, it's an electrolyte solution with powdered coconut water and sea salt. What that does is replenish those electrolytes. As you're sweating, your body's burning that, you really need that. Think Gatorade, but without all the tangible sugar and extra BS. This is pure electrolytes. It comes in one flavor, lemonade. And as a lot of people have asked me, is it really powerful? No. It's meant to be an addition. You can drink it on its own. It's gonna have a slight lemonade flavor, but mixed with things, it increases the power and potency of your already pre-mixed cocktail. But electrolytes, huge. Aminos, great for energy. This gives you mental focus and extra energy because it is a pre-workout. This replenishes your electrolytes. And then this right here is a huge, huge thing. I'm gonna zoom up. If you haven't tried Vasky, you need to. Vasky is a non-stimulant pump inducer. What that means is it's not going to make any of this any more heavy hitting, which is something you would have to watch out for if you're going like pre-workout, pre-workout, pre-workout. You're gonna get wrecked. That's too much stimulant. It's either gonna create a really bad workout or it's gonna create no workout because you're gonna be in the bathroom regretting the entire decision. It's a non-stimulant pump inducer, and especially for someone like myself, I don't eat anymore before I work out. It's not necessarily that I'm trying to go for fasting, but I just don't eat. It doesn't really work well if you eat and then do the type of workouts I'm doing. It's gonna make you sick. I tried it a little bit. The carbs don't help. It's gonna suck regardless, but I'm in it to win it, and I'm ready to suck it up and just deal with it being a little rough. But what the Vasky does is kind of take the place of the carbs giving you that pump. If you train carbed up and ready to go, your body's just gonna have a better inherent pump because it has more going through the blood system. So with Vasky, you get that really good carbed up pump without having to be in a carb state. So you can be fasted while still getting a pump. This stuff was, I believe, yeah, no, not even believe, this was the first MTS product I ever tried. fell in love with it, used it for a year, and they offered me the sponsorship. So, I mean, if you guys didn't know that, I'm an MTS sponsored athlete, hence my bias towards amazing products, which all of these are. They're all like non-patented ingredients. So you know how things have proprietary blends? Doesn't exist in MTS. What is on the label is what's in it. And that's probably one of the sole reasons I love MTS the most. It's because I can look on the back of here and I trust what it says. If something says pump matrix, 3 grams, patented, what the hell's in that? You don't know. It might have L-citrulline in it, but out of that 3 grams, it's 2.5 of that L-citrulline and a little bit of this and a little bit of that. What ratios? And if it is, you could be getting something in here that's in something in here using different types of products. You can cross-contaminate. Creatine is a huge one, people do that. You could have creatine in your aminos, you could have creatine in your pre-workout, and you could have creatine in your pump product. Now you're taking 15, 20 grams of creatine, which is excessive, beyond excessive. That's absolutely useless. Your body's just getting rid of that, and you're spending all this money for ingredients you're not even ingesting. So, non-patented, non-proprietary blend, that's what makes MTS special. These 4 ingredients right here equals MTS runaround punch. What this is gonna do is give you different phases of energy. It's gonna keep you sustained, it's gonna bring you up, it's gonna replenish you, and it's gonna give you one hell of a pump. This is, I think, one huge element of the reason why my training's been as successful as it is. One of these being taken out of the equation would shaft the entire workout. Without the Vasky, I don't have a pump. Without the pump, you just don't get that much out of it. Without the electrolytes, I'm gonna be hurting as that workout gets to an end because I've depleted all of them. Without that pre-workout, getting 6 hours of sleep, working out for 3 hours, you get tired. Your mental focus starts to get evaporated. This gets you back in the game, and the aminos sustain you for the entire time. And then having it in a ready-to-use cup and not have to carry all this crap with you at the gym just makes it that much easier. You don't have to do the concentration trick. I think it works. Hopefully, you guys have MTS products to make the MTS runaround punch. If you don't, utilize your own products, though I'd highly suggest you really pay attention to the back of the labels because they're gonna get a little tricky with the cross-contamination of ingredients. And I suggest that you eliminate those ones altogether and go with MTS, but I'm a little biased. Also, check out the Big Shirt. If you don't know who Big J is, you gotta check him out on Instagram and Twitter as well. The dude's a freaking beast. He's a long time fitness person and a very big, very big fan of his. I like him. Anyways, this is MTS Runaround Punch. It's, I seriously think, one of the sole reasons why my workout, because I'm midway through week 3, I'm just turning and burning, and it seems crazy, and I've had a lot of people tell me my workout style is absolutely, for lack of better words and not cussing on YouTube, crazy, but it's something that's challenging, and if it's not gonna challenge you, it won't change you, and I'm absolutely slayed. I'm setting reminders on my phone to not fall asleep after working out before I have to go to work, but that's a long story. Check out that video on Wednesday to figure out why exactly I'm as tired as I am. Again, MTS Runaround Punch, try it out. If you have any comments, questions, concerns, leave it in the comment section below, and I'll definitely get back to you guys. Thanks for watching. Hopefully everyone's day is going well, getting out there, grinding those goals, making it happen, but most importantly, take it easy.